Dave Parody here with another slide makeover video podcast based on the ideas in my book, The Visual Slide Revolution. Today's slide comes from a conversation I had recently with a trainer, and they have to show screen captures or screenshots of software or websites in their programs, and they were having a bit of a challenge. And let me show you this slide. This is kind of an adaptation, and this is a screenshot of one of my favorite graphics programs called UrfanView. What I'm trying to show here is a certain menu item that I want people to look at. The challenge is, most of the time, this goes up on the screen, and then somebody will go and try to point at it so that you can see what it is that you're supposed to be doing. But there's a few problems here. First of all, the text in the program, those menu items or toolbar buttons, it's far too small for anybody to read. Now, we can read it when we're looking at a computer because we're so close, but when it's projected up on a screen, it can never be big enough to actually be read easily. When you try to use a pointer, whether it's a physical pointer, one of these extendable ones, or a laser pointer, you're pointing at things, but people can't really remember where you are pointing. And then when they go to do it on their own job or they go to refer to that website, they're not really sure where it is that they're supposed to go again because they can't remember what you were seeing or what you were trying to do, or they can't even see it in the first place. If you're doing web-based training or web-based presentations, which many of us are getting into a lot more these days, how are you going to point? Yes, I know some web services do have the sort of web version of a laser pointer, and you wave it across the screen if you can get your mouse to go in the right spot. But still, again, how are they going to remember it? They can't. And if I put this as a handout saying, okay, I'm going to print my slides for you so you can use them as a reference, if I print them in a reasonable size, let's say 4 slides per page, you can't actually see what it is that I've pointed at. And you're busy trying to circle things or make notes, and you're not really paying attention to me explaining why it is you should be using this particular feature or this website. So those are the challenges in the typical way that it's done. Let me take a look at this slide again, and let me show you how I would build it in a training session. So next thing we're going to talk about is how to resize or resample a photograph. And you notice what I've done here is I've shown you the image menu. Let me just bring that a little bigger so we can see it. The first thing you need to do is to click on image, and that brings up the menu for you. Then you click on resize, resample. This will lead us to the dialog box to set the settings that allow us to resize and resample our photograph. So you'll notice what happens now is that I have context because people understood where it is in the program initially, but then I brought it a lot bigger. It's much easier to read it and see it, and then I used visual callouts to show you where it is you're supposed to be looking. So here are some of the lessons from this slide makeover when you're using screenshots. First, always have the entire screen on your slide so that they have context. You'll notice in my example, I still had the full screen behind. I didn't go to a new slide. That's very important because people need to have context throughout your explanation. Second, there will be an area of focus, whether in my case it was a drop-down menu, it might be a particular spot on a website. Take that and make it larger so that people can see it, read it, and now they're clear on what it is that they're looking for. Direct their attention with callouts. I had the callouts around the image and the resize resample selection so that people are really clear where it is they're supposed to be looking. When I print that as a handout, it's very easy. People can see it. They see the callouts around. Okay, that's what I need to focus on when I go back to my desk. And if you are doing a website as a screenshot, the title bar right at the top, which has the URL, is micro printing at best. So put the URL on the slide in larger text, maybe down at the bottom or somewhere else that it's not going to interfere with what you're trying to say, so that when somebody refers to it later, they know what website page they were actually looking at, and then can go in and do the tasks or the procedures that you were teaching them. So that's another slide makeover video podcast. For more information on the training, books, videos, consulting that I do, you can go to my websites at www.visualsliderevolution.com. That's all the information on the book. And www.thinkoutsidetheslide.com. More information about the training, additional resources, and consulting. Take care. We'll see you next time.